Views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of this station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
Good morning, everybody. You are listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. I'm your co-host today. I'm Nancy, and I'm here with Benny and Taylor. Taylor's going to be taking your calls. And, of course, I'm here with Mary Jane. A little bit about Mary Jane. She's my mom. She does alternative health care, and she has an office based in Issaquah, Washington. Although you do not have to live in the state of Washington if you would like an appointment with her. She's a medical intuitive. She's fabulous at what she does. And I just love her to death. And today, we're talking about the holidays, stress, and family.
Well, that's a great topic. And, you know, the holidays really are supposed to be happy and have fun sometimes those stressful situations do come up. But first of all, I have to tell you about the play I saw last night. I saw Les Miserables at the Issaquah Village Theater. Oh, my gosh. It is absolutely unbelievable. It is the voices it was better than the movie. It was phenomenal from the beginning to the end. I'd really like to go see it again. And I was thinking of taking you, Nancy.
Wow. Okay.
So I highly recommend it. It was great.
So that's at the Village Theater Issaquah.
Issaquah. Probably, I think it goes up to Everett after Issaquah. But it's there till January 5th. Anyway, it was great.
So you heard it first from Mary Jane's mouth.
Exactly.
So would that make a good Christmas gift?
Oh, it would. It would. It's 3 hours long. One of their longer plays, but it's one of those plays that from the beginning to the end, or the intermission, the time just flew. I mean, it wasn't one that dragged at all. And the singing in it was so phenomenal that you'll love every minute of it.
All right.
Okay. So families and holiday. So I hear the stories all the time. I have to be with my in-laws, and my in-laws are so nasty. They never change. They're the same. So it's when people never change and they're always the same, it's not up to you. Shouldn't wait for them to change. You have to change, and you have to change how you feel about the situation and what you can do to make it better. And I know, Nancy, you've been in that situation before. So it's like when people are the same, your expectations should not be that they're going to be better if they haven't been better for 20 years. You can send that positive energy and hope that things will change. But at the same time, you have to do what you can do to make that event, say a dinner or whatever it is that you go to, make it the best for your entire family and build on the positive of what is happening at the event, not necessarily the negative of the person.
Which sometimes can be hard.
Can be hard. But you know what? It is what it is. And if you make it hard, it will be hard. And if you only focus on that negative of what somebody's doing wrong, then it becomes bigger. So if you take the focus off that and put the focus on even your own family or other people that at the party that are doing all the right things and doing good things and make it a fun event in spite of that person. Of course, we have a product in our office that helps with that. We have a product that when you take it, it's made by Biotics Research. It helps you deal with that situation and just takes the edge off so that you don't go over the edge. And
so you don't snap. You don't snap at that
yeah.
dinner.
Yeah. Exactly. And it's good for animals, too. A little bit of de-stress.
That's good. Mary Jane will be taking your calls today on the air. So if you have a question about your health, family members' health, pets, anything, Mary Jane will be taking your calls. You can give her a call at 1-800-930-2819. Do you want to explain a little bit more about what you do?
I would love to. So what I do is the accelerated performance system, and it's a technique of muscle testing. And what I do is follow a system. I do the same thing every time, whether you're in the room or I'm on the phone tuning into you. So I check the right side of your body, the left side of your body, and the center of your body. And when I'm muscle testing, your body will tell me in order exactly what you need help with. So, and what I look for is the top three priorities, and the body will not reveal anything that should not be dealt with at that time. So when I'm checking people, I'm following the system, and the system takes me to the top three issues. It could be digestive issues. It could be gallbladder. It could be blood issues, anemia. It could be brain, tired structure issues. It doesn't matter what it is. The body, in its own innate intelligence, knows the answer.
And has the ability to heal itself with the proper nutrition given.
Exactly. And that's when I'm able to identify exactly what the cause is. And I do a technique of pulsing the body from the organ score a 10 when they're healthy. The heart's at 12. So I score the organ from 0 to 10 to see what its function is and how healthy the organ is. So then that tells me exactly what nutrition, say if I get a number of 5, then I know exactly, I ask the body how much nutrition we need to use. And it's all very fine-tuned for exactly what that person needs. So I'm not guessing what you need. I'm giving you the exact amount your body needs to heal itself and repair itself, and then we have predictable results. I know when you take what I recommend that in a week you should be a little bit better.
And I know we have a couple of callers calling in today to tell their story about their results, which is going to be very exciting.
And sometimes it's just, you know, people come in with all these diagnoses, medical diagnoses, and often, again, I don't go by what I listen to what they're telling me, but then I do my technique and check the body and follow the body. And it may not even relate to the person how that relates to what they have. Well, and then I explain how it is all connected. But when you follow the body and you take care of the first top priorities, then a lot of the other things will get well without even doing any other nutrition.
So lots of people coming in with all kinds of symptoms and are actually surprised to find out it could be a digestive issue. Or I think this time of year it's a lot of gallbladder.
Gallbladder.
With all the extra food we've been eating around the holiday time.
Well, and digestive issues are one of the main causes, the research shows today, that's one of the main causes of all diseases. So if you're not digesting, your digestion is off, like your gallbladder is off, well, it backs up your liver, backs up all your other organs and systems, and even your hormones, and so throws everything out of balance. By just correcting the digestion, then everything else, and that's what I do that all the time. You correct the digestion, and everything else will get better. So it's fun. It's easy, it's not complicated, and I always trust the body and know that the answers I get are exactly what they need.
Well, I can attest to what she does because I've been healthy for many, many, many years now, and it's amazing. It's easy, it's quick, it's simple. Like you said, it's not complicated, and it works.
And if for kids, it's even easier. So it doesn't matter what's going on with the kids. The kids could, in your mind, could sound pretty complicated, but it may be something very simple that needs to be addressed, and usually it has to do with digestion, and then everything else can change and get better.
And I also think pets are even better than kids.
Oh, yeah. Well, I think pets and kids are pets have less emotion. They don't hold on to anything. The kids have a little emotion, but the kids don't have a lot of baggage, so they change quickly too. But pets definitely change very quickly.
All right. Well, you are listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. I'm your co-host, Nancy. We're going to take a short commercial break, and we'll be right back after this short message.
Come on, let's go.
Tune in each Wednesday at 1 p.m. Pacific Time, 4 Eastern Time on Transformation Talk Radio to Limelight Radio with Katina Macris. This is an inspirational, cutting-edge radio show educating worldwide listeners on a diversity of Lyme disease-related topics. Each week, Katina will interview some of the world's leaders in health, wellness, spirituality, and human potential. For more information, visit LimelightRadio.com.
Tune in each Tuesday at noon Pacific and 3 Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com for The Dr. Julie Show, All Things Connected with Dr. Julie Kroll, featuring weekly segments with David Eisen and the Chakra Sound System. Each week, you will journey through infinite possibilities, expand into social potential, and find beautiful beginnings where endings leave off. Changemakers from around the world will explore what's emergent about the environment, relationships, health, the arts, education, and the evolution of consciousness. Visit TheDrJulieShow.com.
How would you like increased health and vitality? How would you like to avoid the onset of disease as well as slow the aging process? This is all possible through a simple, safe, and natural process. Every day we are either moving toward wellness or away from wellness.
Hi, I'm Mary Jane Mack. I'd like to be your partner in achieving optimal health. Contact me now at MaryJaneMack.com or call 425-392-0659. Visit MaryJaneMack.com.
Laura Longley is on a mission to remove stuckness from your life for good and replace it with happiness. Tune in Mondays at 11 a.m. Pacific, 2 p.m. Eastern, and Tuesdays at 1 p.m. Pacific, 4 p.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com for The Laura Longley Show, where authentic change takes flight. Say yes to that inspired you and goodbye to your stuckness as Laura and her guests deliver powerful ways to work through common problems in this fun and unique hit show.
Tune in each Thursday at 9 a.m. Pacific, noon Eastern, on TransformationTalkRadio.com for the hit radio show that illuminates the heart-centered bond of animal and human as souls destined to find each other in a lifetime. Each week, this world-renowned animal communicator, through her live call-in show, will assist you in understanding animals as light beings, here to raise the vibrational level of this planet. They're ready. Are you?
Tune in to The Truth Is Funny with Colette Stephan each Wednesday at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This hit show will have you thinking outside the box and riding the wave of infinite potential. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success while roaring with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. Visit TheTruthIsFunny.com.
Go back. This is the moment. Tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over. So we put our hands up like a ceiling can hold us. Like a ceiling can.
Welcome back, everyone. You're listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. Your co-host, Nancy. I'm here with Mary Jane. We got Benny doing the boards, all the controls, and Taylor answering the phone. Just want to remind everybody, Mary Jane is taking your calls. You can give us a call at 1-800-930-2819. And I think we're going to go off to the phones right now and talk to Barbara. Hi, Barbara.
Hi.
How are you?
Oh, I'm fine, stressed. But
how can I help you, Barbara?
This past summer, my mother moved in with me. I felt it was a choice that I needed to make. To help her, to be there for her. And I am realizing that there are some severe mental health issues. And I'm not exactly sure where to go with this or how to deal with this. She can be fine and wonderful one minute, and the next minute turns against you.
Okay.
Christmas is coming, and she states, well, if so-and-so's going to be there, I'm not coming.
Okay.
And she's talking about my daughter, which is, you know, hurtful.
That doesn't work. That doesn't work.
Is there like a tea or something wonderful that I can give to my mother to?
Well, there's all kinds of herbal teas that are calming.
What about Rescue Remedy?
Rescue Remedy that you could buy over the counter is good. So there are things that you could do for that. Your mom, is she on any medications?
My mom refuses to take any kind of pill.
Okay. Yeah, so then you have to get her the Rescue Remedy or the sleepy time tea, but one of those herbal teas.
Sleepy
may
time.
Not want to knock her out, but that's the best thing to do. I mean, you probably need a little Rescue Remedy yourself. So it's about not putting, you know, take the focus off her, and if she doesn't like it, she can speak up, but don't pay any attention to her. Can you do that?
Sometimes it's really hard.
But can you?
I tend to walk away.
Yeah.
I can.
I mean, it's like, don't make it a discussion about your daughter coming or not coming, because she is coming. So don't even talk about it. Just end it like that, because if you have, I think she probably sounds like the person that if you're going to talk about it, it's going to wind up to be a major back and forth bantering, and that doesn't go anywhere. So just do what you're going to do, and don't give her the energy to get all riled up. Does that make sense?
Yeah. like Remedy. Where would I find this?
Rescue Remedy, you could get at any store in like the...
At a health food store, maybe a Whole Foods might have a Rescue Remedy.
Yeah, they have it.
It's a liquid. You just put it in some juice, or you could put it in water, or you could just
put it in your mouth.
Put it in your mouth, but it sounds like your mom probably won't put it in her mouth.
Well, you could put it in her juice and give it to her, or whatever she's drinking. And it just calms you down a little bit.
Takes the edge off. And that's what it's called, Rescue Remedy.
All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Barbara. Hang in there. All right. And then we have our next caller, Mary Kay. Hi, Mary.
Hello.
How are you?
Hey, Mary Kay.
I am good. How are you?
I'm doing very well. Great party on Saturday. Thank you again so much. Had a great time.
Thank you for coming.
Mary Kay is our cousin from Chicago, the Chicago area. And Mary Kay... started coming to my office, called me, or she came out here.
No, she came out to visit on business, and she came out in June. And before that, I had told Mary Kay a little bit about what mom did, and she kind of looked at me with a strange look, like most people do. But when she came out to visit in June, she actually talked to my mom about it.
And she had some major health issues at that time. So, Mary Kay, I'm going to let you tell the story about your health issues and your experience.
Okay, great. Well, I was diagnosed back in 96 with scleroderma, which is an autoimmune disease. It's pretty rare and obviously no cure for it. And in addition to that, I've always had arthritis. I had arthritis even as a kid, but it was always very manageable. The scleroderma, luckily, you know, stayed pretty dormant. There was no progression. I was seeing doctors, my rheumatologist, twice a year, and everything was pretty much staying the same. It was just that I had joint pain and horrible fatigue, and because my schedule and I travel all the time too, there would be times where I would come home on a Friday and I would literally get in bed and not get out of bed until Monday morning when I had to go back to work because I was so exhausted and just my joints hurt so bad. And then probably about 5 years ago, they did some testing and they said that there was some progression, that I had pulmonary fibrosis. And that was really impacting my breathing. I was having a hard time. I could no longer, I'd walk up a flight of stairs and you would think I ran a marathon because I just had such a hard time breathing. But it was just something that I lived with. It just became normal to me. So when Nancy did talk to me about this, and I don't think I looked at you funny, Nancy, but I said, okay, I'd be interested to hear what Mary Jane has to say. And so you did your testing on me and put me on the nutrition program that you thought was best for me, and that was back in June. And I can say quite honestly that within 2 weeks, my joint pain was gone. I no longer had, my knees were probably the worst. I couldn't sleep at night because my legs hurt, my knees hurt. I couldn't do anything. And within 2 weeks, I saw a difference. Within a month, I would say I was completely pain-free. And so you've been adjusting kind of as we go along, you know, the different nutrition. And then I was scheduled to go in for all of my follow-up testing, which I do yearly. And all of my blood work has come back normal, but probably even better than that, when I had my pulmonary testing done, it had reversed itself. And my lung doctor was even quite taken back by that, and his comment was, just keep doing what you're doing, but there is no need for you to continue to have these tests. I have to obviously see him every year just so he can listen to my lungs, but he said I am in complete remission. And everything looks good. So,
and he also said something about he's never seen that happen before.
He has said that he has never seen it actually reverse because there was some thickening, and they told me that when that happens, you can't reverse the thickening. But it somehow it has reversed, and so I am a total believer. And you know, recently just did 2 5Ks with my family, and something that 6-7 months ago, there is no way in the world I could have done that with the pain in my joints. So for anybody who is a non-believer or somebody who wants to give the Nancy the look that I gave her, I would say listen to them, try it, because I am living proof that it works.
Great.
Yay. Thank you, Mary Kay.
Yeah, so we love success stories, and we see quite a few success stories. And here's the interesting part with Mary Kay. It wasn't, it wasn't complicated. We worked on some digestive issues and kidney and bladder issues, and just doing those things, then everything got better. So it wasn't like this big, complicated, oh, we got to treat the disease. We just treated the body. And as the body had what it needed, it healed itself, and her lungs were totally better.
Yes, and she did run a 5K, a couple of 5Ks back-to-back, yeah. And she said back in June there was no way she would be able to do that again. Yeah. So, and she did it in 10-degree weather in Chicago. So
we thank you, Mary Kay.
Thank you, Mary Kay. Love you. I'm glad you're feeling good, and keep up the good work. So that left a phone line open. If you'd like to ask Mary Jane a health question about yourself or a family member, give us a call at 1-800-930-2819. If you'd like to know more about Mary Jane, you can call her office at 1-800-777-4232 and talk to Rhonda.
And if the line is busy, Rhonda's on the other line. So just
leave a message and
she'll
get back to you.
Yeah. So good.
It's all good.
So
after the break, actually, it's almost time for a break. So after the break, we'll go ahead and talk a little bit more about the holiday stress. Again, if you have a question for Mary Jane, go ahead and give us a call at 1-800-930-2819. You're listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio, and we'll catch you on the other side.
Shine bright like a diamond. Find light in the beautiful sea. I chose to be happy. You and I, we're like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star. A vision of ecstasy. When you hold me, I'm alive. We're like diamonds in the sky. I knew there would be.
Holistic Medical Center is where you find it all. A healthy space with doctors who care, see, and listen to the whole you. Hi, this is Dr. Darvish. If you have not found an answer to your chronic symptoms, you will find answers here at Holistic Medical Center. Our doctors find the root cause of your symptoms and guide your body towards healing naturally. We transform lives from within. Visit drdarvish.com or call 425-451-0404.
Tune in to Peace World Radio, vibrant conversations to change the world with Christina Jantz, each second Monday at 11 a.m. Pacific, 2 p.m. Eastern Time on TransformationTalkRadio.com and KKNW. This hit show is energetic, vibrant, and an engaging forum that's getting people talking. Christina brings you extraordinary and courageous people, bold in thought and action, who dare to dream that things can be different. Peace World Radio. Join the talk the world is having.
Chris Stainis is a spiritual leader and healer and teaches a course on how you can transform your life through a meditation and healing system that will manifest your spirit's dreams. She manifested the Women of Wisdom Conference, the Women of Wisdom book, and this radio show. And she can show you how to change your life too. Are you ready? Visit the website and contact her at voicesofwomentoday.com. That's voicesofwomentoday.com.
Hey, do you like free stuff? The Dr. Pat Show has an amazing giveaway program doing weekly giveaways on Facebook and Twitter. Go to facebook.com/thedrpatshow and click the like button. Then go to twitter.com/thedrpatshow and click the follow button. Then you can play along and enter to win some amazing prizes. Again, that's facebook.com/thedrpatshow and twitter.com/thedrpatshow.
Where do you desire to go in life? How do you plan to get there? Are you only looking outside yourself for the answers? What if you use your soul's wisdom to lead the way? So what is the soul, and how do you access its wisdom? Soul Suitcase with Victoria Cohen will unpack these questions and help you tap into and trust your own inner voice to solve everyday problems. Your Soul Suitcase is a treasure chest of wisdom inside you waiting to be discovered. Listen to Soul Suitcase on TransformationTalkRadio.com and discover how awakening to your inner voice transforms your life.
The Tick-Borne Disease Alliance, TBDA, has just launched Bite Back for a Cure, a new national grassroots campaign to build support for the fight against tick-borne diseases. This fall, 24-year-old John Donnelly is biking across America to meet others affected by tick-borne diseases and raise awareness about the national tick-borne disease epidemic. TBDA wants you to get involved in the campaign and follow John's journey. To learn more, visit bitebackforacure.org.
Welcome back, everyone. You're listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. I'm Nancy, and I'm here with Mary Jane, and I think we're going to go to Kathy. Hi, Kathy.
Hi, Nancy. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Hey, Kathy.
I'm great.
Thanks for calling. Now, Kathy's from Chicago area also, and Kathy, we want you to just tell your story.
Well, I don't really know how we got started talking about it, but Mary Jane knew that I needed help. And unlike Mary Kay, the previous caller, I had a whole boatload of problems in my kidneys, my heart, bladder, stomach, thyroid, everything was all out of whack. And I don't know how Mary Jane knew that I needed help, but she reached out to me. And in addition to all of that, I had so much emotional baggage. She directed me to talk to Lonnie, who's been a previous guest on the show. And I can tell you that here I am, pretty happy, pretty healthy. One example I can give, I was out the other day shoveling snow, and all of a sudden I got this big smile on my face. I didn't have chest pains. I wasn't hurting. I shoveled mine. I shoveled my neighbors. I shoveled the other neighbors. And I couldn't do that before. I couldn't do it. I just didn't have it in me. And it's all because I'm on proper nutrition. And anybody who's doubting that it works, please give it a try. You have nothing to lose. There's nothing harmful. Like if you get medication from a doctor, you don't know if you're going to have a reaction to it, what it's going to do to you. Everything Maryjane gives you is healthy for you. I even give it to my dog. I'm pretty particular about what I do with my dog. So if I trust her with my dog, I definitely trust her.
And Kathy's had a big year. She's had some major changes in her life and major decisions to make. And because she was able to get healthy, it helped her make those decisions easier and clearer without as much frustration, I think. Wasn't it, Kathy?
Well, I've learned with your help to put myself first. And I never did that before. And it makes the biggest difference in the whole world. I can't help anybody else until I fix me. And I will say to everyone who's listening, I'm still a little dented and bruised and dinged up, but I'm not broken anymore.
Oh,
that's exciting.
That's very exciting. Yeah. And anybody who can shovel snow and have a smile on their face, God bless them. Because it's cold back there.
It's about 18 degrees right now, but I can't tell you. I don't worry about things. I just approach things one at a time. But it's because I'm getting what my body needs to function.
Yeah, and it's a process. It's a process. Mm-hmm. When you've had all your life of getting kind of beat up and not taking care of yourself, but taking care of everybody else in your life, it's a change and a process to be able to get to where you are today. And you've done a great job. And I'm so proud of you for getting, finding that road and knowing that you were worth it and that you continue to do things to help yourself and change and be the best mm-hmm. you can be. So it's fun.
That's what I try for every day, but I wouldn't have taken that trip without you. And I wouldn't be where I am today without you.
Oh,
thank you. Thank you so much, Kathy.
Thank you, Kathy. Love you.
We love you and appreciate you.
So it leaves another line open here at the Maryjane Mack Show, 800-930-2819. The number again is 800-930-2819.
Thank you. Okay, Maryjane, a little bit more about the holiday and the stress and what we can do about it.
Well, for the holiday, just be prepared. Write your gratitude list. Think about what is it that you're grateful for this past year and what this past year has brought you that has made a change in your life. And when you make that list, sometimes it's little things that may be important. But what pivotal things happened to you this year that made a difference and took you in another direction? So I think it's really important to slow down and think about, go back to January and go month to month and write those things down and be grateful for them and have count your blessings.
Instead of counting what you don't have.
Well, and the other thing, remember, is when you have challenges and trials and tribulations, those are all things who make you who you are today. And when things aren't going well and you keep hitting bumps in the road, then you have to think about, well, why is that happening? To me, that's a red flag that might be going in the wrong direction. Or sometimes people are losing their job, for example. If someone's in a position they feel they're being pushed out of their job, then look at what is that really about? Maybe you're not supposed to be in that job and the universe is nudging you to be doing something else and there's something better for you. So instead of looking at the downside of what that's about, look at the other side and what's your next step? Where are you going? What other blessings are there for you? And are you really doing what you want to do? And so make that list about what you're grateful for, what this last year has brought in for you, and keep that as a diary. Keep that every year
And then with the new year coming up, I think it's also good to make a list of what you want to bring into your life.
Exactly.
Because I think the more we focus on what we want, we're able to bring that in.
Well, and the other thing about that is you can't be vague. You can't talk about, even if you have an issue or a problem going on, if you don't know all the details and know exactly what it's about, then how can that you come to a conclusion with it? Like if something's going on and things are breaking in your house and other people are in charge and you don't know what the contractor's doing, but he's going to take care of it. Well, when those kind of things happen, and that can be in all different types of details, when that happens, it's the universe is telling you to pay attention, stand in your own power, and know what's going on. And no one can take care of you better than you. And it's the same if you're going to a doctor and you don't know, the doctor's telling you what to do and giving you medication and directing you, but you don't even know what it's for or why you're doing it. That's not standing in your power. And part of your wellness program, no matter what it is, whether you're doing a nutrition program, whether you're following your medical doctor, is to be informed and know what you're doing. And that's part of you standing in your power. And that's what we're talking about for the next year, is look at what is it you want to bring into your life that helps you to be better grounded, better at who you are, know who you are, and know what you want to bring into your life. And it has to be very specific. If it's vague, you're not going to get it.
So it's like Kathy said, I think we all are probably guilty of not taking care of ourselves first, putting ourselves first, but we always put others first. Sometimes that's easier to put others first because some people really don't want to take a look at what's going on in their own life so they can, scatter it around.
Exactly. It's like moms taking care of their kids all the time and they're so stressed out because the kids have issues. The kids may have health issues. So now the mom's getting worn down, and pretty soon the mom's getting sick because she hasn't been taking care of herself. So it's a good time to plan some time for yourself no matter what. No matter what's going on, take time to go for a massage maybe. Take time to be alone if you have to go somewhere else to do that. And I
think everybody can find at least 10 minutes in their day, whether that's waking up early before anyone gets up in the house or after you get the kids and everybody put to bed. There's always 10 minutes at night that you can find to be alone and just kind of relax and focus on what you want and how you want things to be for the next day.
And if you write it down, it's even better.
Because make the list.
Yeah, make the list, because when it goes from your brain to the paper, it's as if you've already done it. So now you're taking it from just thought to more action.
And dreaming big. I mean, it's kind of like the safari for myself. I knew I was going to go to the David Sheldrick Wildlife Trust, and I knew what was going to happen, and it was going to happen the way I wanted it to happen. And 5 years later, I was able to make the trip, and it was like a dream come true. So dreams do come true.
Yeah. And you were very specific and you knew what you want and you held it.
I did.
You didn't falter. You didn't think, oh, I'm not going to get it. It might not work. You never thought that. So you have to keep a positive attitude and draw it to you by thinking the way you think.
And also, I think by letting yourself know you deserve to have something happen, because a lot of us, I think, feel we don't deserve to have good things happen to us.
Exactly. And if, you know, when things are happening, you have accidents in your life, for example, you have things keep going wrong. Remember that that's like a wake up call again. Pay attention to why those things are happening. It's not like you're such a bad person. The universe is trying to get your attention to guide you in another direction, and sometimes it has to bump you a little to wake you up. And if you're paying attention to that, you could change direction and and make it a fun journey, not a hard journey.
Exactly. Change is not always a fun thing, but you have to change in order to move forward.
Right.
You are listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. If you would like to ask Mary Jane a question, give us a call at 1-800-930-2819, and we'll be check you out on the other side.
What if there's nothing wrong with you? What if you're far greater than you've ever given yourself credit for? What if it's time to know the gift and the contribution you are to the world and to like yourself a lot more? Hi, my name is Dane here. 13 years ago, I started to truly ask questions. Actually, I started to be the question, and everything changed for me. Asking questions opens doors to infinite possibilities. And it's not about finding the answer. It's about being the question. Always. What I'm inviting you to step into is something that Einstein, Marie Curie, Newton, Da Vinci, Gandhi, Picasso, and Aristotle all knew to be true. What if no question is too big or too small? What if anything is possible for you? What if together we could create a kinder, gentler, happier world? Is now the time? Go to beingyouclass.com and sign up for a free video series, My Gift to You. Beingyouclass.com. What if you, truly being you, are the gift and change this world requires? BeingYouClass.com.
Tune in each Wednesday at noon Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com for the hit show Out of the Fog with Karen Hager. Spark your spirit and ignite your soul with spiritual conversation and enlightening guests that'll help catapult you into action. You'll meet metaphysical movers and shakers and light workers guaranteed to raise your vibration. Karen's down-to-earth style and lively curiosity is what makes this show super special. Visit FogCityPsychic.com to find out more and to book your private intuitive reading today.
How would you like increased health and vitality? How would you like to avoid the onset of disease as well as slow the aging process? This is all possible through a simple, safe, and natural process. Every day we are either moving toward wellness or away from wellness.
Hi, I'm Mary Jane Mack. I'd like to be your partner in achieving optimal health. Contact me now at MaryJaneMack.com or call 425-392-0659. Visit MaryJaneMack.com.
Tune in to Intuit University, compassionate guidance connecting you to your inner wisdom with internationally renowned psychic and medium, Sherry Dillard, the second and fourth Thursday each month at 12 p.m. Pacific Time and 3 p.m. Eastern Time. Get ready for an hour of practical spirituality and a fun and magic carpet ride into the spirit realm. This hit show is a combination of call-in readings and intuitive mentoring as Sherry supports and empowers you to create your best life in relationships, career, finances, life purpose, and spirituality. For more information, visit SherryDillard.com.
Tune in to The Sandy Brewer Show, getting to the heart of what matters in your life. Thursdays at 1 p.m. Pacific, 4 p.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com and experience the powerful healing voice of Dr. Sandy Brewer, one of call-in talk radio's most dynamic, compelling personalities. Get ready for inspiration and contagious humor and her been-there, done-that, no-nonsense advice to meet today's challenges.
Listen and call in at 800-930-2819 for The Sandy Brewer Show.
Welcome back, everybody. You're listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. I'm your co-host, Nancy, and I'm here today with Mary Jane, and we're talking about the holidays, stress, and family.
And the important thing for the holidays is to stay healthy. And remember, when you get stressed out, that affects your immune system. So you want to, again, don't try and stay. Look at what you can do to stay calm and have a good time versus being stressed and ruin everybody else's time.
Oh, I know. It's a difficult time. Christmas is probably my favorite time of the year. I just love the feeling. I love the music. I love the lights. But then you get into the traffic with all the crazy people and the pushing and shoving at the mall. So I think we all have to remember, just take a breath and have some fun.
Yeah,
enjoy
exactly.
The feeling of Christmas and what it's really all about.
And think about healthy choices. Remember, this is the time for digestive issues, that's for sure. So make make healthy choices. And remember, when you're cooking food, don't be eating leftovers that are left in the refrigerator more than a couple days. That's how you get food poisoning. And think about when you make those foods, make them as fresh as you can. Use fresh ingredients instead of processed, and especially for the kids. And you'll have a healthier start for yourself before you go to these different parties where you get a variety of other nice things.
Yeah, and I think when you do go to those parties, my motto, moderation. You know, I think if you want to have a little bit of everything, that's good, but don't have a lot of everything.
Exactly.
Because then you just feel miserable because now you've eaten, you know, 3 pounds of stuff that probably aren't going to be
but
happy with.
Just have fun.
And
have
don't
fun.
Worry about it. And don't get guilty about it. I think we have Maria on the line. Hi, Maria.
Hi. Thank you so much. This is perfect timing. My 13-year-old daughter, she trains for basketball. She's very tall. She's 5'10". It's the only sport she does. But she has been having, and it's not an asthma, but more like a shortness of breath. That kind of takes her off guard while she's playing ball. And we went to the doctor who said that it wasn't asthma. She wonders if it's just deconditioning. And I'm just not sure what else to consider.
Okay, I can tell you what's going on with her. First of all, what she has is what we call a toxic stomach. She has a lot of bacteria in her stomach. And how you get that, you can get it from eating microwave food. You can get it from your house, the drains being bad in your house, where you need to clean your drains with a good drain cleaner. And you do need to clean your drains in your house because your house scores a 3. And when those gases come up from the drains, you know, there's black mold and crud down there. You breathe in those gases, and then it gives you a sick stomach. Then all those toxins go through your gut and through your kidney and your bladder. And her problem is it's starting in the stomach, but she has a kidney and a bladder issue, and that's what her lung issue is. So you start with the stomach. Like if you were to call our office, we'd put her on a program and pull her out of that in a very short time. So it's a stomach issue, then it's a bladder kidney issue. And that's her lungs score a 2. So her lungs are definitely in low gear because of it. But it doesn't take much to turn that around. Does that make sense?
Okay. But it's not affecting me.
Well,
I don't feel the same symptoms.
No,
but
it is affecting you. It is affecting you. Everybody, you know, she's more active and busy.
Yes.
And now you know, you could get along fine if you don't push the body and you're not exercising. But now, now her body is, she's
being
doing more. Yeah.
Right.
But it's easy to change. It's not complicated. However,
okay.
if you have to do the drains and then put her on you call Rhonda and we'll get an appointment for her and put her on a program and she'll be out of that in no time.
Oh, very good.
Absolutely. Right. Look forward to talking to you.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Maria. And Mary Jane Mack's office number is 888-777-4232. Go ahead and...
Okay, I'm going to have to bring up those drains again.
The drains.
That's all drains. This is the most common problem I see. So now about this time of year, kids are getting colds, they're congested, sinus problems. Some are it can go into the breathing, it can go into like nausea. Feeling tired. Oh, fatigue is big because when you get a toxic stomach and then you get a kidney and bladder issue, that really makes you tired. And so even if somebody came in to me and I put them on a nutrition program, unless they do their drains, they will not get better. That's how important it is. And if you were to really look down your drains and see what's down there, then maybe you wouldn't have to be convinced about what
to do. It's a scary place.
So you have to use an industrial cleaner. And if you do them really a heavy duty, what I see is people, whatever it says, the amount, if you haven't done them in years, probably need to double the amount especially in the showers. Showers and tubs are always the worst. And then they usually will last 4 or 5 months before you have to do them again. But it causes dogs to and cats to have itching problems, kidney problems, bladder problems, and it's all from the drains.
And I have to say, when Mary Jane says the gas is coming up, not necessarily will you smell these gases, but the toxins and everything are coming up through the drains. I have actually had this happen at my house, so I had to go ahead and clean those drains out again. So you're not necessarily smelling something coming from the drains, but they are pretty disgusting.
Yeah, and you wouldn't know it at all. And again, it's the drains, but the other thing is if you're microwaving. That's another way you get a toxic stomach. And when you get the toxic stomach, it really affects your kidney and bladder. And so then sometimes we could head it off with just treating the stomach, but other times we have to do the whole package to get better.
Yeah, microwaving should now be used as a storage cabinet. It was kind of hard to get me off the microwaving when Mary Jane said, should microwave your food. I was a little resistant and thought, well, what's the harm in doing, frozen veggies in the microwave? But I eventually stopped. Well, what is the harm of doing frozen vegetables in the microwave?
Well, it kills the food. Yeah, the food is dead.
So you're not getting any nutritional value from whatever you're microwaving.
And that's giving you a sick stomach immediately. So it's like I'll say, do you microwave? Oh, no, I just warm things up. Well, if you keep coming up with the same problem and your stomach is always sick, the warming it up is killing you. So is it worth it?
Exactly.
It's not worth it. And you hear people, especially when people are getting organic food, they're cooking everything properly the way they should, or buying the food, and then they put it in the microwave. You might as well just throw it down the drain because it's not going to do you any good. When it's in the microwave and you eat it, it's negative to your body. So what I look at is I score everything from 0 to 10. And 10 would be it's really fresh. So it has to be a 7 to 10 to be good. If it's less than that, then it's negative to your body, and it slows the body down. And when it slows the body down, that's when you get tired. That's when your gallbladder gets backed up. That's when your kidneys get backed up. Because when the body gets tired, now it can't move that sludge out. And that's why you wind up with these other problems. So by staying ahead of it and doing some simple things can make a huge difference. And especially people who've got kids in school now and they're getting sick because the houses are closed up too in the wintertime. But you get those drains done and you'll change the way your kids, if they're sick all the time, they won't be sick all the time.
So it's every drain in your house.
Yeah, except you follow the directions on the drain cleaner.
So it's all your sinks.
An industrial drain cleaner.
All your showers. And that should take care of the problem.
Showers and tubs are the worst because you got to think about the hair and the different soaps and what you use down them. Absolutely. And then if people have drains in their basements, open drains, you might not put an industrial drain cleaner down them, but you might need to use something like bleach or something else and then cover those drains so the gases don't come up. Something simple. It doesn't have to be complicated.
Exactly. Keep it simple. That's what Mary Jane does, is keeps everything simple.
But I can't tell you enough about what a difference that makes to do the drains. I mean, I tell you all the time. And in my office, I see it all the time, and it's just a common thing. And you think about the sewers and everything and how things get backed up, it's pretty easy to do that.
It's a simple fix.
Yeah.
So that industrial drain cleaner.
Well, it's a big thing to keep everybody healthy in your house, including your pets. So get it done and breathe easy.
All right. Well, it's the holiday season. Mary Jane, do you have any words you'd like to share with everyone?
Be grateful for all that you have and the people in your life, even if they are a challenge. And do your gratitude list and enjoy the holidays. Have some fun. When you're out, talk to other people. I mean, don't
give somebody a smile.
Yeah, just smile and and make it a good time. And sometimes even if you don't feel like doing that, once you do it, it can change everything.
It can. One smile can change one person's life.
Exactly.
And really make a difference in their day.
Well, tell what happened to you in Starbucks again.
Which time?
When you went through Starbucks.
Oh, I went through Starbucks, and I went ahead. I was going through the drive-thru first thing in the morning, and I have a habit of always buying the person behind me coffee. But I went up, and the person in front of me had bought my coffee. So it was kind of like a great appreciation. So I just hope everybody has a very Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, be kind to each other, and we will see you next year.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Sometimes you're crazy, then you wonder why. I'm such a baby, yeah, the dolphins make me cry. But there's nothing I can do. I only wanna be with you. You can call me a fool. I only wanna be with you. Yeah, I'm tangled up in blue. I only wanna be with you. Only wanna be with you.
TransformationTalkRadio.com, where transformation is inevitable.
Well, I'm in the trouble, and the trouble's in me. This reality, what I see blasts my eyes, runs down my spine like a lightning rod. But I don't know who to blame for it, 'cause it's just an act of God. Well, there's so much pain here, but there's so much good. People do more beautiful things in times of trouble than I ever thought they would. I said I really cared before, that was a facade. I guess you never know the truth till you know an act of God. And if God makes the sunset, and he makes the deep blue sea, the earthquake, the tornado, the typhoon, the volcano.